Welcome back. So we're going to talk a little bit about dependency injection now. I already kind of made dependency injection and used it inside my customer service right now, but of course the code don't run yet and I'm not started using that inside my console app yet. So we'll start working on that in the next couple of lessons. First of all, I just want to give you guys just an idea about why dependency injection is kind of awesome. There are some good things about dependency injections and there are some bad things with any kind of code, right? Now the cool thing about dependency injection is that, notice right here, I don't have to put in any new keyword here inside my customer service. I just know that when the program is running, somehow, somewhere, somebody will provide me a customer repository. Now this is very powerful, especially when we need to start doing testing. And it's also very powerful because I can actually decide which customer repository I want to use on runtime, meaning that I could make a repository that's only usable for test and another repository that's usable for running on a production environment. That might not be a good scenario, but still, it's my choice. I could also choose that I want to move now from a repository that works with an SQL database into a repository that works with a NoSQL database, or into a repository that kind of just saves everything as a file. But I don't have to consider that until runtime because of the way I made this code. Because there's no keyword, there's no new keyword. If I went in here, just to give you guys an example, and I put in the customer repository, and I said specifically, I want it to be a new customer repository. Notice the first thing is I would have to know about a customer repository, meaning that I would have to have a dependency from our core application downwards to our infrastructure. Now that's something we don't want. We don't want this guy to have information from the outside circle. So that's the first no-no. That's the first reason why I would never do it. But let's say that I actually added that dependency. So I knew about this customer repository right here. Let's just try and do it. Customer repository. So let's say that that guy was actually there like this. I know it won't work because I didn't add that dependency. Now, if I want to later on go and change this now, I would probably have to go a lot of places and start changing this customer repository because let's say I want to switch to this guy and I use this implementation in multiple customer services, maybe in the customer service, inside the order service, inside blah, blah, blah. I use this repository multiple places. It would mean that I would have to remember to go and change it all the places, or else I would end up actually using one repository for one part and another for another part. So let's just use dependency injection instead to kind of get up and running with this. And the power of it, dependency injection, is pretty much that on runtime, I can decide what implementation class I want to use. That's the real power. And it also means that I can start mocking my implementation classes. Don't worry, we'll get into it when we start unit testing. But it means that I can just make fake implementations of this interface without ever knowing what they should actually, how they actually work inside the infrastructure. So the interface part is all about keeping this application with the core, knows about the interfaces, and the outside world, the outer bounds, they have to provide on runtime how they want to use the interface to do some kind of task that I've asked them to do, right? So again, the interface is just a contract, and on runtime, then whoever wants to do whatever I ask them to do will use this contract to, in this case, create a customer repository that can pass into the system. But how do we use this? And especially inside a console app, well, actually, we need to do some magic here in the next lesson inside our main application. We start using dependency injection here. And Microsoft didn't actually make too much documentation on that because, to be serious, not a lot of people make console apps as production-ready apps. But still, we're going to do it in the next lesson where we're going to try and dependency inject everything so we can start having one place where we control what each interface, how they react with their implementation. That's it for this lesson. See you next time.